If all goes to plan, next month SpaceX will launch the largest rocket in human history. Towering nearly 400 feet tall, the rocket, Starship, is designed to take NASA astronauts to the moon. And SpaceX's CEO, Elon Musk, has bigger ambitions. He wants to use it to settle humans on Mars. Much has already been made of Starship's human spaceflight capabilities. But the rocket could also revolutionize what we know about our neighboring planets and moons. On Monday, December 6, SpaceX founder Elon Musk participated in Wall Street Journal's CEO Council Summit, where he was asked about the next-generation launch vehicle the company is developing in South Texas. Starship is a hard project, he said. Starship is under development to achieve returning NASA astronauts to the moon and sending the first humans to Mars. The launch vehicle consists of a spacecraft and super heavy rocket booster that will become the world's most powerful rocket, capable of propelling to orbit double the mass of the Saturn V rocket that took Apollo NASA astronauts to the lunar surface. Unlike Saturn V, SpaceX aims to create a fully reusable Starship that will completely revolutionize space exploration. If achieved, Musk says that Starship will be a profound revolution in access to orbit. There has never been a fully reusable launch vehicle. This is the holy grail of space technology. It is the fundamental breakthrough that is necessary for humanity to become a spacefaring civilization. The aerospace company has been manufacturing and testing stainless steel prototypes of the spacecraft since 2019. Multiple vehicles conducted test flights into altitudes under 20 kilometers. Engineers are getting ready to conduct the first Starship orbital flight test, sometime in January or February 2022. Starship absorbs more of my mental energy than probably any other single thing, Musk shared during the summit's video conference. But it is so preposterously difficult that there are times where I wonder whether we can actually do this. The interviewer asked Musk why Starship is a hard project, and Musk briefly explained the main reason why it has been difficult to develop the two-stage launch system. We live on a planet where the gravity is actually very strong. We actually live on the densest planet in the solar system. Our atmosphere is very thick, and what this comes down to is that a typical orbital rocket might be able to put about 2% of its liftoff mass into orbit, he said. To my knowledge, no rocket has ever lifted about 4% of its liftoff mass to orbit, adding that, in order to make a rocket fully reusable, you've got to basically create a rocket that can do about 4%, if not more than 4%, of its mass to orbit, which hasn't happened before, he explained. That means that you have to have a pluses across the board, incredibly efficient engines, incredibly efficient structure, you do need scale, that's why Starship is so gigantic, he said. There's so many things that have to be done to have Starship and Super Heavy Booster be reusable, including creating a super light heat shield. It's incredibly difficult. Many smart people have tried to do it before and no one has succeeded. Most have kinda just given up halfway through, Musk said. But if full and rapid reusability can be achieved, it reduces the cost of access to orbit by a factor of 100 or more. He reiterated that Starship should be as reusable as an aircraft or automobile, with the only maintenance being fuel. He says that reusability is necessary because it will make the difference between humanity being a multiplanet species or a single planet species. It's really that big of a deal, Musk said. Central to many of these ideas is that Starship is designed to be not just large but cheap to launch. Whereas agencies like NASA and ESA must carefully choose a smattering of missions to fund, with launch costs in the tens or hundreds of millions of dollars, Starship's affordability could open the door to many more. The low cost of access has the potential to really change the game for science research, says Andrew Westfall, a lecturer in physics at the University of California, Berkeley, with flights potentially as low as $2 million per launch. You can imagine privately financed missions and consortia of citizens who get together to fly things. What's more, Starship has a key advantage over other super heavy lift rockets in development, such as NASA's much-delayed Space Launch System and Blue Origin's New Glenn rocket. The upper half of the rocket is designed to be refueled in Earth orbit by other Starships, so more of its lifting capability can be handed over to scientific equipment rather than fuel. Taking humans to the moon, for example, might require 8 separate launches, with each consecutive tanker Starship bringing up fuel to the lunar Starship, that then makes its way to the moon with scientific equipment and crew. Scientists are now starting to dream of what Starship might let them do. Earlier this year, a paper published by Jennifer Heldman of NASA Ames Research Center explored some of the scientific opportunities that might be opened by Starship missions to the Moon and Mars. One great benefit is that Starship could carry full-sized equipment from Earth. No need to miniaturize it to fit in a smaller vehicle, as was required for the Apollo missions to the Moon. For example, you could bring a drilling rig, says Heldman. You could drill down a kilometer, like we do on Earth. That would afford unprecedented access to the interior of the Moon and Mars, where ice and other useful resources are thought to be present. Before, such an idea have been a little bit insane, says Heldman. But with Starship, you could do it, and still have room to spare, she adds. What else do you want to bring? Because Starship can land back on Earth, it will also, theoretically, be able to bring back vast amounts of samples. The sheer volume that could be returned, from a variety of different locations, would give scientists on Earth unprecedented access to extraterrestrial material. That could shed light on a myriad of mysteries, such as the volcanic history of the Moon or the question of life and astrobiology on Mars, says Heldman. Starship could also enable more extravagant missions to other locations, either via a direct launch from Earth or perhaps by using the Moon and Mars as refueling stations, an ambitious future envisioned by Musk. The entire vehicle will be capable of lifting 100 metric tons, 220,000 pounds of cargo and people into space on regular low-cost missions. The volume of usable space within Starship is a whopping 1,000 cubic meters, big enough to fit the entire Eiffel Tower, disassembled. And that's got scientists excited. In mid-November, speaking in a publicly accessible virtual meeting about Starship, hosted by the U.S. National Academies of Sciences, Engineering, and Medicine, Musk discussed the project's scientific potential. It's extremely important that we try to become a multiplanet species as quickly as possible, he said. Along the way, we will learn a great deal about the nature of the universe. Starship could carry a lot of scientific instrumentation on flights, said Musk, far more than is currently possible. We'd learn a tremendous amount, compared to having to send fairly small vehicles with limited scientific instrumentation, which is what we currently do, he said. You could get a 100-ton object to the surface of Europa, said Musk. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.